Hey Matterporters, thanks for joining me again. In this customization video, I want to talk to you about the highlight reel. The highlight reel is where you actually get to create your guided tour. It's important to remember that when you're out there scanning, you're actually not creating a guided tour. What you're doing is fleshing out a 3D model. The highlight reel is not necessarily only used by real estate agents to handhold their home buyers through properties. It can be used by so many different use cases to increase the efficiency of navigation through that model. So for example, with construction, if you want to quickly lead somebody through a checklist of things that need to get repaired, if you're an insurance estimator and you want to quickly go through the property, that highlight reel can help you navigate to exactly what you need to see in order to create an estimate for your customer. So let's go ahead and check out how to create a highlight reel for your model. I've gone ahead and already clicked the edit button to get into workshop, and right here is my highlight reel tool. I'll just click that and up comes an empty highlight reel. Let's get rid of this. Now what I can do is just move around this model. I can go into the dollhouse view, for example, to see it from a different angle, and I can just click the add view button right here in order to add this view, what I'm seeing right now in my view pane, to the highlight reel. So I'll just go ahead and do that. And you can see the highlight appeared right here. Now, before we go any further, I just wanted to go over some of the things that you'll see in the highlight reel. Right here, you have the number of highlights that are in your reel. And here is the edit button that allows you to edit the default settings. So let's go ahead and click on that. And you can see here, I can edit the transitions from either slideshow to walkthrough. I'll just go ahead and choose the walkthrough in this case. And I can choose the walkthrough speed, make that a little bit faster. Slideshow transition speed, because I'm using walkthrough, in my case, this is not relevant. And I'll go into panning. I'll go ahead and leave mine on auto right now. What I can do after the default is set, if I want to edit a specific highlight, is to just go into that highlight by itself and change the direction of the pan. I can also edit the rotation angle right here. If 35 degrees isn't quite enough or a little too much, I can edit this here. Again, I'm changing the default for all the highlights, but I can always go into individual highlights and adjust the rotation angle just for that specific highlight. The rotation speed is set here. Dollhouse rotation speed, which is a little bit different, so I wanna speed this up a little bit. And down here, you have the ability to edit the floor plan zoom speed. So I'll just leave that set to medium and click done. As soon as I roll my cursor over the highlight, you'll notice a trash can icon allows me to remove this one highlight, or I can edit this specific highlight as I was mentioning before. Down here, I can see the transition selected with this highlight and the rotation. So currently the rotation is set to auto, but if I edit, I can change that right here. And again, this is specifically for this highlight only and will not adjust the default settings that I had set previously. And let's go ahead and put in a couple more highlights. I'll just go inside and I'll add a highlight of the kitchen. Because I'm starting over here on the right side, I want to make sure that the pan is to the left. So I can come over here, click the edit highlight and choose left and then click done. Now I'll come over here, and in fact, I want to go maybe to back to the dollhouse and see this from this angle, add this view, and then I'll add this view from the inside. And again, edit this and say pan to the right. Not only can I add views that I'm currently looking at, like the dollhouse or inside view, but I can also bring in photos that I've previously captured using the photos tool. Right here with this button, up comes the previously captured photos. These were automatically generated by the system as the model was being processed. All the 2D photos that I had previously captured would also be displayed here, minus any 360 photos that I'd captured, because those just can't be added to the highlight reel. So let me choose to add this bedroom, for example, this dollhouse, and then maybe this bathroom. And then I'll click add, and you can see that the bedroom was added, and then the dollhouse, and then the bathroom, in the order that I had selected those photos. Now, if I just want to clear everything and go back to the very beginning and start over with creating my highlight reel, right over here in the corner, you have this clear all button. And if I click on it, you get a confirmation window so you don't accidentally delete your entire highlight reel. I'll just go ahead and hit no. I'll go back to the dollhouse view and add one of these as my last scan position, and I'm done. Another thing you can do with your highlights is give them a caption to help your visitors navigate through that reel. So for example, these three that I brought in from photos already have captions, because those photos were named. If those photos were not named and just went with the default time and date that they were captured, nothing would be listed here. But I can always go in and change this by clicking the edit button, click on the caption, and change this to second bedroom. Click the arrows over here to go on to the next one. I'm going to delete this caption because it's not necessary to say dollhouse. And I'll go to the next one, say bathroom, go to the next one here, and go all the way back to this one. Let's call this one living room. And I can just go through and add captions to whichever highlights I choose. Click done, there we go. So you'll see these captions listed here in the highlight reel, but the visitor is not going to see them appear in the main view as they're being guided through the reel. You'll also notice that the highlight that's currently selected has a red border. I can click on any other highlight to navigate directly to that position that was previously captured. And if I want to see what the highlight reel looks like being played from this position, I can just go ahead and hit the play button right here. Once you're all done creating your highlight reel, you can just close out of the tool and hit the preview button to see what it looks like. Just go ahead and hit the play button at the bottom and the highlight reel begins to play. And that's really all there is to it. Creating a highlight reel is super simple and can tremendously help your visitors more quickly and effectively navigate through the model.